I can't say that I would do what you did. You didn't run, you stayed, and you held these two men as they were dying in your arms. How did you do that?
Something wouldn't let me run. Like, everybody was running out the door and something wouldn't let me go. And so I was kind of kneeling on the ground and I had my hand on the guy's arm and I moved it down and his hand was down and I had my hand over his hand and I could kind of feel his fingers like wrapped around my hand, wrapped around my fingers. And then as the guys were basically, I could still see their backs, were running back in, I felt like a squeeze on my fingers and then I just felt the fingers go loose. So we called his mom and I said, I promise you, I swear to you that I will not leave him. I will stay with him until this is over. And then she started telling me about him, you know, that he's covered in tattoos and that when he was younger, they called him Blimpy or Blobby because he was blimpy when he was young. I was there until about 3:30 in the morning. So for about 4 hours, I was sitting with him. But I would like to think that if it was me, that somebody would have let me sit there alone.
I think Jordan will be with you always.
I don't want him to be a John Doe.
He's not. He is not. You are a hero. His name and who he was and what his mother called him when he was a little boy will be remembered forever. Heather, thank you for what you did from all of us.